Sometimes if you work with Cisco gear and you're working with the newer stuff, you could get so used to it behaving a certain way that perhaps a throwback from the old days might mess you up. What I find interesting in the CCNA virtual labs that are provided for when you take the class, there's actually a way to see something that you may rarely see on real gear. Let me bring this up and show it to you. I got the environment here, switch one, switch two. So I'll bring the two switches up. There's switch one. Let's go ahead and clear out the screen there, unpolluted. Let's get switch two. Gotcha, that's already pretty clear. All right, so here's what I want to do. Let's go ahead and get back out to just global config mode on this switch. You'll notice that it's titled there, switch one, but it's just called switch. So just for me to keep track of what gear I'm on, I'll go ahead and give it a host name, SW1, and make this guy match. He's switch two, so SW2. Oops, I guess I gotta type the word host first. There we go, so I named it. Let me get these up a little higher. But if you look at the diagram, I'll shrink this down, you'll notice that there's a link between the two switches. Well, I would like that to be a trunk. Let's go ahead and bring that. And again, if you are on a fairly large number of Cisco devices, switches, that you will find that if they are connected directly together, they will become a trunk. May not be what you want, but you could expect that behavior. Well, if I examine these guys, I'll do a show interface trunk and find out. Well, it says it's in desirable mode, Ethernet 00, and that's the connection that's between these two switches. So, you know, I don't want it to be desirable. In other words, I don't want it to figure it out for itself. I want to hard code it. That's always best practice anyway. Here's the behavior I'm talking about. If I go into interface Ethernet 00, say I want to hard code this guy to trunk, check out what it tells me. Hey, the encapsulation is set to auto. Well, this is a device that supports both ISL or 802.1Q trunking protocol. And if you happen to have a device, real or virtual, that does support both, then you have to tell it which one you want. So here we go. I will do, in fact, let's see if I did. I think I created a notepad file. There we go. Switch port trunk encapsulation.1Q. Of course, I can shorten version of the commands because I want to do this on both, and rather than typing it twice, let's go ahead and copy this. Get back up to my switches. So let's go ahead, configure terminal, interface Ethernet 00, and I'm going to paste in what I just copied. Boom. And then to make it match on this side, paste it in again. Oops, I guess I got to be in interface Ethernet 00. Now paste it in. Now they should match. Okay, I got one duplex mismatch pop up before I was able to hard code the other side to match. But now that I've done this on both sides, and you see the advantage of copy and pasting, get it done faster, I'll do a show interface trunk again. Look at the changes. Now it's on, in other words, hard coded. It is no longer ISL, negotiated ISL. Now it's just 802.1Q. Good stuff. So that's the kind of cool stuff we get to do in class. In fact, let's go ahead and check our environment. If I get the switches out of the way, you'll notice I have a PC, I have a router. Let's check connectivity. Let's get on the PC and do a show IP interface brief. Find out my address is 10.10.1.10. Show IP route, find out that my gateway is 10.10.1.1. That's going to be the IP address of the router. Let's check it out. Ping 10.10.1.1. Bam, success. All right, so just one little insight. And as I pointed out, you don't have to do exactly what the lab says. If you're studying, practicing, hey, they run the iOS. Go ahead and lab out to your heart's content.